So we meditate, so we may be at peace, so we may be in bliss. But after that meditation, then what do? We meditate so when we go out in the world, we can be better people at that time. We go out so that we can be more compassionate, so that we can be more loving and caring and more in a sense of equanimity. Regardless of where you work, in a 2-people company or a 2,000 people company, regardless of where you live, what kind of family you have, you may have no conflict with people if you are really good, but still you may have a difference of opinion. And if you don't know how to handle that difference of opinion, you will feel agitated very quickly. And that agitation leads to a sense of frustration. And that frustration leads to a sense of anger. And then we confront the other person in the wrong manner. And when we do that, first, we don't get the point across. Secondly, we ruin our own peace of mind. But if at that time you're aware, just before reacting or just before acting, if you're aware, then that awareness will stop you from saying things you didn't mean to say. It will make you question yourself for a fraction of a second. Because if you don't hurt other people with your words, your meditation, your prayers, your dhyana, your rituals will become multifold, many, many times more effective. Otherwise, what happens? Rituals remain empty. Prayers remain hollow. Words have no impact. We quickly go, we do an aarti. You know, with the devotion you sang while I was just came, you were singing, with the devotion you were singing, if you can muster the same devotion day in, day out for a little while, you will experience that silence. But what happens at home, there are other dimensions in play, other things happening there. And while doing that, we lose that touch with ourselves. And you cannot, when you call out, the same feeling does not come out. And that's what a champion is, one who's consistent. If you can bring the same feeling day in, day out, day in, day out, day in, day out, then the goal, the destination, or the end of the journey is not far. You know, by saying the word destination or goal, I may give you the wrong idea. I may say that there is something you have to aim for. No, there is nothing you have to aim for. Existence doesn't aim for anything. Nature does not aim for anything. Aim and ambition is the human way. Just to be, to flow, is the divine way. And that's really the only difference between humanity and divinity. Divinity is when you don't leave your humanity under any circumstances. And I have a beautiful poem for you. It's a bit long, but... So I suppose anybody here who understands Punjabi, by the way? Oh, quite a few, all right. So there was a Punjabi poet called Bulle Shah. So it's written by Bulle Shah. I'll read it and translate it as we go along. Pad pad alim fazil hoyo, kadi apne aap nu padhya nahi. He's saying, listen, you are becoming such a scholar by reading all the scriptures, texts, you're a learned man. But did you study yourself? Swadhyaya vyasam cha vangmem tapuchyate. Krishna says, before you study scriptures, yes, that's even a tapas of the vani. But to study yourself is also a matter of great austerity, penance. Pad pad alim fazil hoyo, kadi apne aap nu padhya nahi. How many people have really sat down and analyzed themselves. That, okay, I find things wrong in the world. I find things wrong in other people. I'm not happy about this, I'm not happy about that. But really, who am I and where do I stand? If one day you do this written exercise, you would get a picture of you that may surprise even yourself. It's really never ever underestimate the power of writing things down. So that contemplation, who am I, will come later. Write down, you know, who am I? What do I stand for? How do I behave? What drags me into the world and what drags me out of the world? Just not that typical SWOT analysis, but something similar. You know, what do I stand for? What am I? Not how people see me, how people perceive me, but how do I perceive myself?
ਪੜ੍ਹ ਆਲਿਮ ਫਾਜ਼ਿਲ ਹੋਇਓ ਕਦੀ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਨੂੰ ਪੜ੍ਹਿਆ ਨਹੀਂ ਜਾ ਜਾ ਵੜਦਾ ਏ ਮੰਦਿਰ ਮਸੀਤੀ ਕਦੀ ਆਪਣੇ ਮਨ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੜਿਆ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੰਦਿਰ ਮਸਜਿਦ ਤੋਂ ਫਟਾਫਟ ਚਲੇ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹਨ ਮਾਥਾ ਟੇਕਣੇ ਖੁਦ ਕੇ ਭੀਤਰ ਜਾਣੇ ਸੇ ਇਨਸਾਨ ਘਬਰਾਤਾ ਹੈ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਯੂ ਡੋਂਟ ਨੋ ਵੇਅਰ ਯੂ ਮੇ ਐਂਡ ਅਪ ਟੂ ਐਂਟਰ ਇਨ ਯੂਰ ਓਨ ਵਰਲਡ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਚੈਲੇਂਜਿੰਗ ਥਿੰਗ ਵੀ ਕੀਪ ਪੁਟਿੰਗ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਕਵਰਸ ਔਨ ਵਟ ਵੀ ਡੋਂਟ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਸੀ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਆਰਸੈਲਵਸ We just slip it under the carpet and say, it's all good, it's all good. I'm just going to dress up nice and I'm going to, you know, put some stuff on and I'm going to look very good and that's my reality. But is it? Because you can fool others, but we can't fool ourselves.
So, jaja vadde mandir masiti, kadi apne man vich vadya nahi.
We have to enter into ourselves. And that's what really meditation is. To know more about yourself. What does your mind talk when you're quiet? One thing that happens to people when they start to meditate is their life turns upside down. Because anytime they can't go to sleep, they recall how talkative their mind is. And sometimes they think, was it also talkative? This much earlier, I never felt that way. And now it's just talking all the time. That awareness takes you a step closer to yourself.
ਐਵੇਂ ਰੋਜ਼ ਸ਼ੈਤਾਨ ਨਾਲ ਲੜਨਾ ਹੈ ਕਦੇ ਨਫਜ਼ ਆਪਣੇ ਨਾਲ ਲੜਿਆ ਨਹੀਂ
ਵੀ ਆਰ ਇਟਰਨਲੀ ਫਾਈਟਿੰਗ ਵਿਦ ਦੀ ਅਦਰ ਪੀਪਲ ਵਿਦ ਦੀ ਐਕਸਟਰਨਲ ਵਰਲਡ ਬਟ ਹੈਵ ਯੂ ਐਵਰ ਲੁਕਡ ਐਟ ਯੋਰ ਓਨ ਸ਼ਾਰਟ ਕਮਿੰਗਸ ਐਂਡ ਫੌਟ ਵਿਦ ਦੈਮ ਦੈਟ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਰਾਈਜ਼ ਅਬਵ ਮਾਈ ਓਨ ਲਿਮਿਟੇਸ਼ਨਸ ਮਾਈ ਓਨ ਵਿਊਜ਼ ਪਰਸਪੈਕਟਿਵਸ ਐਂਡ ਸੋ ਔਨ
ਬੁੱਲੇ ਸ਼ਾਹ ਅਸਮਾਨੀ ਉੱਡਦਾ ਫੜਨਾ ਹੈ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਘਰ ਬੈਠਾ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਫੜਿਆ ਨਹੀਂ
ਯੂ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਕੈਚ ਵਟਸ ਐਪ ਦੇਅਰ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਜੋ ਆਸਮਾਨ ਮੇਂ ਉੜ ਰਹਾ ਹੈ ਸਮ ਗਾਡ ਅਪ ਦੇਅਰ ਇਨ ਅ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਟ ਵਰਲਡ ਯੂ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਗੈਟ ਅ ਗਲਿੰਪਸ ਆਫ ਦੈਟ ਗਾਡ ਬਟ ਵਟ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਦ ਵਨ ਦੈਟਸ ਵਿਦ ਯੂ ਐਟ ਯੋਰ ਹੋਮ ਇਨਸਾਈਡ ਯੂ Is that no longer important because just because you have it? Haath hao to but haath na ho to khuda ho. Once I have access to you, you are just a normal human being. If I can't have access to you, you are God. That's human mentality. But more than that, that's the mentality of a restless mind, a talkative mind.
Rab rab karde budde ho gaye, mulla pandit sare. Rab da khoj khura na labba, ate sajde kar kar hare.
It doesn't matter who you are. People have grown from young to very old by doing those rituals, by praying, but they have not found even the beginning of where God is, or who God is, or how God is, or what God is like.
Main falsafi ko door ko suljha raha hai, sira milta nahi. Behas ke andar falsafi ko khuda milta nahi.
That thing with intellect, it's a strength, no doubt, but it's also the greatest hurdle on the path. Because intellect gives you the illusion that you know what you think you know. And that's why when you sit down and meditate, we are quieting the intellect as well at that time. We are saying, listen, you don't do the talking, you don't come up with intelligent stuff, I don't want you to tell me this is right or this is wrong. For some time, I need you to be quiet.
so that I may see through you. If a child is making a lot of noise, they naturally get or attract the attention. So when mind makes noise, it gets your attention and then it drags you with it. But if it's quiet, then you realize that, okay, you know, there is something happening beyond it. So this is saying, let's be quiet.